Hong Kong's air cargo hub takes a flying step forward. In a competitive global air freight environment, Hong Kong International Airport's annual capacity jumps some 50% after last year's opening of the Cathay Pacific cargo terminal. Making Chep Lap Kok arguably the most efficient airport in the world for flying freight, as it's rated busiest airport globally for cargo traffic at over 4 million metric tons per year. It puts Cathay Pacific Services, the airline subsidiary that designed, built and now operates the cargo terminal, in the spotlight to perform.
Our vision is to become the world's best cargo terminal in terms of innovation and customer services. We provide total logistics solutions. We understand the need of the airlines as well as our customers and the freight forwarders.
The terminal currently handles and monitors a throughput of 2.6 million tons of cargo traffic annually. And its competitive advantage relies on a just-in-time operational model. When it comes to processing through Hong Kong, this reduces the dwell time of cargo from 8 to 5 hours.
Our terminal control center actually proactively monitor all the process and activities in the cargo terminal with accurate flow of information and data. And we provide instant update of the information in the warehouse operating systems to enable our customer to provide real-time tracking of their cargo coming. So that means a piece of cargo coming from other parts of the world through Hong Kong, through our cargo terminal, we use less time and with more connection.
All of this is music to the ears, particularly of Hong Kong's major trading partners in Europe, as they see consignments begin to pick up from the economic uncertainties of the past few years.
When it comes from Europe, for example, having connection to China or having connection to Southeast Asia, they will have instant connection with 5 hours connection time or even 3 hours with some special arrangement in our cargo terminal. We have a lot of shipments coming from Europe through this cargo terminal because of the operation of the airlines. And Hong Kong is a gateway for transshipment to other parts of the world.
The terminal's state-of-the-art materials handling system includes both container and bulk handling. It gives the terminal that competitive edge, both regionally and internationally, and on a four-story set of levels that's modest in terminal space compared with others in the world.
We use a lot of technology in our cargo terminal. To call an example, for truck control, we use RFID technologies. When a truck is passing through the truck booth, the RFID tag will trigger the material handling system to pick the cargo for immediate collection by the truckers. That helps to enhance the productivity and reduce the dwell time by the truckers. And if the cargo has connection right away from Hong Kong to China, for example, that will further reduce the trucking time and reduce the cost as well for connecting out of Hong Kong. And the system provides flexibility and enable the movement of the cargo from levels to levels. And we have flexibility to change our import and export model from one level to another, which allow more flexibility comparing to some other cargo terminal.
With transshipment facilities, a perishable cargo handling center, and quick transfer capacity, the terminal is a perfect point from which to view the trends in air cargo traffic to and from the Asia Pacific.
We are seeing steady growth of the cargo in 2014, starting from the beginning of this year. But the situation is still very challenging. All sorts of cargoes are coming through this cargo terminal, from iPhones, perishables, flowers, pharmaceuticals, garments. So I think there are more electronic goods are coming through the cargo terminal these days. And we are seeing more perishables from other parts of the world coming through Hong Kong and getting into other places.
As the terminal strives to drive down dwell times for cargo to just 3 hours in Hong Kong, drastically reducing costs for trade operators and airlines, it weighs the possibility of nearly doubling its own capacity to 4 million tons per year, particularly with the prospect of a new runway in Hong Kong, further linking the SAR to international and regional destinations.
China is developing very fast with their infrastructure, and they have different cargo terminals in different airports. But Hong Kong still has an advantage over others because of our policies, legal system, and the custom procedures.